something. This is hopefully something I won't kill. These are my praying mantis eggs. That's what this is. So we're gonna have a praying mantis opening. I had to run out to the mailbox and get it so they didn't, so I don't have fried praying mantises. I have grapevines and I have some other plants out there. And then I also saw that really impressive video of the praying mantis making short work of that Asian murder hornet. We don't have murder hornets. I'm in Virginia. We're on the other side of the country from the murder hornets. But I didn't think it would hurt to start my own little colony of praying mantises here just in case. We have what they call cicada killers. And those are actually beneficial. But we do also have a lot of Japanese beetles and stuff. But praying mantises are beneficial. So didn't think it would hurt. So in my box, here's my box. Keep that address label away from you. They gave me this little booklet of all the bugs I can buy if I want some more bugs. I'm not going to order ladybugs because the guy that had this house, I told you earlier in another video that he had planted like 30 grapevines, and the guy after him pruned them and killed all of them but two. So I think he must have been cultivating ladybugs, because periodically during the year I will have a ladybug infestation in my laundry room. And I think ladybugs are just absolutely gorgeous, and they are beneficial. They must be cat sushi, because my cats love to eat them and they will go nuts to catch and eat them. So I don't need ladybug eggs because I got plenty of ladybugs. They will also capture and kill spiders. That's for another video, though. It's disgusting. So this is my praying mantis in a can. So there's a little hole in the top, breathing hole. So let's just open it. Oh, look at them. They're so cute. They're little baby eggs. So there's supposed to be two of them in here. Here's one. Here's one. And then there's another one down in here. Instructions. So we're just going to leave them in here. The box says contains two egg cases. Praying mantis. It says indoor hatching. Simply place your hatching habitat in a warm area out of direct sunshine. Check every few days for hatching. The egg cases will need approximately 70 degrees for 2 to 6 weeks to hatch, depending on when the female laid the eggs. Release the baby mantises as soon as hatching occurs. So today's the 16th. So we should be seeing baby mantises by the 30th, maybe. We'll see. I have a good place for it. Out in the laundry room. The laundry room does not have ductwork, so it doesn't get any air conditioning. So it'd be a nice warm place for that. But not in the sunshine, because I guess we don't want baked mantises. But I could put them outside. So maybe I should do, since I've got two, I could do two. It says, attach the egg case to a twig or place in the crotch of the plant about 1 to 2 feet off the ground. When hatching, the young crawl out from between two flaps and hang from silky threads about 2 inches below the egg case. Once the egg has hatched, it does not change in appearance. Well-camouflaged babies will disperse within an hour. So I think I'm going to keep one in here, and I'll attach the other one to my little Meyer lemon tree. See which one, see what happens. We'll check back in on it every now and then. Praying mantis legs, eggs. There's supposed to be like between 50 to 100 of them in each egg case. So let's just start a pretty nice little colony of praying mantises. I certainly hope they hatch. And then I also got lacewing eggs, green lacewing eggs. I don't know whether you've seen them. They kind of look like little flat, like leaves. They're supposed to be really good for your plants too. And this says, they're target pests. They will eat aphids, mealybugs, thrips, spider mites. Release instructions. Please open to the red arrows above. Hang slow release bags from the branch, the plant branches around infested area. Do not lay flat on soil. Leave release bag on plant for no less than 10 days. May be stored up to 14 days at 50. So that's what these look like. These are little baby lacewing eggs. I think I'm going to take them out and hang them on the grapevines. That's what they're there for. So it says, thank you for your order. It was $12 for the praying mantis and the lady with the lace wings. Let's see if they work. Hopefully I'll be able to capture some of them on the film, but we'll see. But that's what I got! They're supposed to be beneficial bugs, so I do have the writing, the little script, the ones that write, I have the spiders outside, and they're kind of yellow and black, and they write, they do the writing outside, and I tell you, if you happen to get bit by one, it's not very pleasant. I have gotten bit by one. I didn't realize I had reached over, and it was in the brush, and it bit me. It's not fun. But they're amazing, because they write some of the most, they create some of the most beautiful spider webs, but they're outside. I never see them inside. But I do get the grandang long legs and the wolves in here, but I haven't seen them in a long time because, like I said, the cats love to eat them. So we don't see them very often anymore because they make short work of it. So I am going to put